So a while back, I started this project over building a cranberry bog settlement. And then after a little while, I teased the idea and the progress of the settlement on November 19th of 2020 on Twitter, as you can see. But I am just now getting around to uploading it and giving a tour over this place. However, I'm not going to be touring the bunker quite yet in this video, just because this video would go on even longer if I tour it and go over things down there. I just feel like I'm rushing myself to explain things. But consider leaving a like if you'd like me to upload an in-depth tour over the bunker soon. Let's see if we can surpass, I don't know, 500 likes or something. That'd be cool. I have updated it quite a bit since the last time I previewed it, and I'm still currently updating it a little. Anyways, during this video, I'm not only going to be doing an in-depth tour over this settlement, I'm also going to be trying to provide other information that I think may be beneficial for you, such as some useful building tricks. I'm also going to be going over things that are around this area that I think may benefit you, and why I chose this specific location in the Cranberry Bog. I have to admit, this was kind of a challenge to build, just because the idea was to incorporate the Cranberry Bog's terrain majorly with this settlement to make it feel hopefully unique. As we know, the environment is filled with loads of ditches and unique red flora too, which looks awesome. However, there's a good reason why we don't see many camps out in the Cranberry Bog. For one, there are loads of nukes that fly over to this environment to spawn the Scorch Beast Queen, you know, the endgame boss fight. So definitely don't want your camp to accidentally get nuked by building too close to where the Scorch Beast Queen spawns. That's just one. We want to make sure we don't want to get too close and accidentally get our camp nuked. But anyways, for two, there are loads of enemies around which can get pretty annoying encountering all the time while being at your camp. And for three, simply the environment. It can be a challenge to build at with all the ditches and uneven terrain. But anyways, the first step I did to starting this settlement out in the Cranberry Bog is, of course, looking for a decent location to build at. Once again, the idea was to involve the terrain majorly, so I started looking around for good ditches I could build in, and came across this wonderful location with a nice open ditch. It also has pre-made structures here too, and a scavenger cutting freaking wood. As silly as this may sound, once I seen this scavenger cutting wood here, my mind was made up with this location to build a settlement at, because I knew he would help make the settlement feel more lived in. It'll actually feel more like a settlement. And there's more to this scavenger woodcutter besides just him cutting wood. He's actually pretty beneficial to have around. He can, for one example, give you 3 bulk wood if you give him 20 caps for the extra wood that he has cut. That's 90 wood scraps. Also, there's other things that he can do as well. I'll be getting more into all of this after the tour of the settlement, just because there's quite a bit of options to go over with this guy. Oh, and by the way, sometimes another ally will spawn here too. So in a way, you could have 2 allies at your camp here as well at this location. The Raider Punk, the Wanderer, and I've even seen the Forager back here chopping up wood. They all spawn here. And what's insane is, once again, you can have your ally placed at your camp and it'll seem like you have 2 allies here hanging out. It's pretty awesome, but for the most part, the Scavenger Woodcutter does spawn here. It's more rare to see another ally spawn here. Although, the unfortunate part is a group of random enemies do spawn here and can take out the Scavenger. Plus side is, he can defend himself, as you can see. And there's not too many enemies that spawn here at once. Maybe like 3 to 5 or so. And sometimes these enemies can be legendaries too. So yeah, that's also definitely a plus. I have seen quite a few legendaries spawn here. However, if encountering enemies at your camp isn't really your thing, trust me, it's not really my thing, to be real with you. I did find out later on, after creating this settlement, that there is another woodcutter nearby, but I still wouldn't have went with this one, just because, once again, I wanted to involve the Cranberry Bog's ditch, and there's not really one over here that compares to the one that's over at the area that I chose. But this is still really close by. I mean, he's not so close where you'll have, you know, 2 woodcutters at your place, but he's still not far whatsoever, as you can see. He's located right here, actually, on the map from the camp icon. He was so close, I wasn't thinking that someone would be able to place their camp down by that woodcutter if I had my camp down here by this one. But turns out I was wrong. As you can see, I can't have a neighbor with a woodcutter, too. Pretty cool little setup if you have a buddy or someone that wanted to have their camp close to yours with the scavenger as well. Oh, and if the scavenger and ditch really isn't your thing and you're kind of looking for a location to build at in the Cranberry Bog, there is a uranium deposit nearby this location too you can build your camp at.
I hope we can set up more settlements like Foundation.
It's located right over here from, once again, my camp icon. And something else to note about this uranium deposit location is that there will be a random war event taking place here between the Blood Eagles against something else. Such as, for example, it could be against a group of glowing mole miners, Scorched, or it could even be against friendly settlers or raiders. And I found out if the friendly raiders or settlers survive the fight, they'll stay here for a while, but they won't stay here forever. For example, when I fast traveled away and came back to this location, they were gone. So that's also something else to keep in mind. You could have an army of settlers or raiders at your camp here, you know, temporarily, if you do decide to choose this location with the uranium deposit. So yeah, hopefully some of that information was helpful for you. Now let me go ahead and show you for reference from Vault 76 exactly where this settlement is built at. I have been showing you like references of other locations around it, but I haven't exactly shown you from Vault 76. So yeah, if you're looking to build at the spot that I built at, here's exactly where I created this settlement at. Keep in mind of the other locations that I've shown you in this video too. Those are also some other pretty good Cranberry Bog locations to try out. And to top it off, all of these locations are located right by a cranberry farm. So yeah, it's pretty convenient if you use cranberries as an ingredient for what you make often, such as for making cranberry cobbler or relish for bonus experience. And there's also plenty of brain fungus around in this environment, which is handy to make brain fungus soup or brain bombs because they can up your intelligence. But keep in mind, brain fungus soup and brain bombs don't stack. However, brain bombs or brain fungus soup can stack with cranberry relish or cranberry cobbler or something. You know, now that I think about it, cranberry bog camps aren't all that bad. Sure, it can be kind of tricky to build in the environment at times, but overall they can be pretty useful. Anyways, let's go ahead and get into a tour over this settlement now. You can just see Watoga off in the distance. Looks pretty sweet. But yeah, I'm going to be entering from the ditch here into the settlement. As you can see, I got an entrance set up from the ditch, because that's how this originally even came into existence. I wanted to really incorporate Cranberry Bog's terrain with this settlement to make it feel like something that could actually be in the game. That was the goal of this build. Also, I did not build all of this alone. I had help from Crooked 60, Mystic Storm 9431, and Bob Thor. They helped out quite a bit with this build, so don't want to take full credit for building all of this. But yeah, as you can see for the entrance here, we got some foundations set up flowing around in the ditch, and I will say it can be a pain to get these to flow how you want through these if you do attempt something like this. Also, there's some gold ore over here too, right at the entrance. A couple gold veins. I did go over a lot on why I chose this location, but yeah, that was another perk that I found out after I already started building here. Has some gold ore. As you can see, there's two different chairs and they look beat up. The idea over this whole settlement was to make it feel like, you know, scavengers lived here. So that's the reason why there's just two different chairs, and you'll just see random things here and there all throughout this settlement. It's supposed to feel like scavengers were settling here. But yeah. Anyways, carrying on. Here is the end of this walkway through the ditch. And I just wanted to incorporate the ground a little bit here. I mean, I could have done something else, like I could have made rugs go across here and connect to this foundation, but I decided to just go with the flow and end it right here and start it right back up over here. And as you can see, here's what the architecture looks like. I wanted to talk about this real quick just because if you notice, there's two different walls here, and that's on purpose. It's to give it more of like a junk wall feel, like, you know, scavengers used what they could to make this. Like, for one example, Bethesda did this over at the crater, the Raider settlement, with this structure here. As you can see, it's combined with wood and the rusted metal look. This kind of setup definitely gives me wasteland vibes. It looks as if they used what they could to put it together. And that was the goal out of this. These are like kind of like custom junk walls in a way. I know there are those nice ones that you can get in the atomic shop. However, you can't really make exactly designs like this with those atomic shop junk walls. Although, they do look nice, don't get me wrong. I unfortunately missed out on those, so I don't have them. But yeah, anyways, inside this door here, right before going into the central area of the settlement, inside here, it's supposed to be as if, you know, a quest giver or someone would be in here. And that's how we'd start a quest to go off on an adventure. That was the idea. And by the way, that was Crooked 60's idea for that room. And I thought that was really creative. Makes it feel like it has more of a purpose. You know, for pretend, that is. Imagination. Anyways, carrying on here. As you can see, I got the central sign set up as if it's just like laying there in the corner instead of actually hanging up on the wall. To make it, I don't know, feel as if just scavengers put it there to get the point across of what you're about to be going in. Also, there's a stove there and a large toolbox. Speaking of random items, those are some for an example. Anyways, entering into the center area, this is what it looks like. Once again, random things around, of course, going with the scavenger settlement theme here. Also, this, by the way, that's broken. This, by the way, was a pain to set up to get the foundations to flow how we wanted. I will mention that. If you do attempt to build in ditches, it can be a pain. Like, for one example here, I couldn't get the foundation to place. As you can see, there's a big hole there underneath the rugs. You know what? I'm going to move these a little better so you can see a little better. Bam. So yeah. As you can see, there's no foundation there. And the reason why is because for some reason, it kept saying it was not able to be placed. It sucked. Because there's not really much there. I don't know exactly why it couldn't be placed. But something that helped do the trick was just placing these rugs over that gap. Definitely a neat little trick. I believe Crooked 60 did this to fix this little problem too. I could have done that out here too. To connect them if I wanted. It could have been a possibility. But I think what we have going on here with incorporating the terrain looks nice. Makes it feel more a part of the ditch and like a cranberry bog settlement. Anyways, carry on. Let's get back in here into the center area. Sorry, I'm doing all this live. If it's a little unprofessional or anything, I apologize. But anyways, also here at the center area, we got a bunch of workstations that we can utilize too. So not only is this place for looks, it's also a functioning camp where players can use like an armor workbench, weapons workbench, or tinker's workbench, whatever they need. It's all around here in the center and easy to find. Also, I got a farm over here too. Now, there are loads of gourds here. I know, some of you may be thinking, what in the world? Why are there so many gourds? That's taking up so much budget. I know, it does take up quite a bit of budget, but I didn't want to make this camp only for looks. I want it to actually be functional, where players can come here and hopefully it'll help them out in some kind of way. Like for instance, gourds are used to make cranberry relish. That's why there's so many. And how I got so many placed in this one dirt tile foundation is by blueprinting them. Bob Thor did this for me. Once again, in order to do this, you're going to have to blueprint like two of them and then place them down as a blueprint if you're interested in trying this yourself. Also, there's a little chicken coop here, too, at the end of the farm. Just because I felt like it belonged. And they give off a nice subtle ambience for the farm area. Also, it blends well with the theme of the structures around in this settlement with the rusted metal and wood. So yeah, that's another thing about this place. It's functional for players. But anyways, I guess from the center area here, let's go ahead and go this way. Right off the bat here to our left, we have my shelter, which I'll be getting into the shelter after I do a tour over this settlement. So stay tuned for the shelter tour in the future. Anyways, on this side over here, we have the Cranberry Bog Settlement's doctor. This is where the doc would be checking up patients. All settlements, I feel like, need some sort of doctor. Really beneficial. And outside here, we just got like a little porch with a bit of greenery outside. These are for pretend to be herbs, as if the doctor was growing these for some kind of medicine or something. Some more herbs right here too. Kim's on the fridge, the Arctis Pharma fridge. Once again, also, if you noticed around, we got the rusted walls blended with the original wood walls. They blend really nice. Anyways, carrying on, let's go ahead and head on up these stairs. This is actually supposed to be, I believe, the scavenger woodcutter's house that's right by here, because he talks about building up this place is hard work. And I'm assuming this is the place he has built up. Pretty cool. This is a pre-made structure, too, in the game from Bethesda. So, don't think I placed these kind of walls or something around. But there were some things added in here. I believe Crooked 60 decorated a lot inside of here. Oh my gosh. The petrified corpse exploded underneath the bed. But yeah, the bed and all of this isn't originally in here. This crate is, though. And this table. I believe these rugs are, too. Let me go ahead and just go into build mode and find out. Yep, the rugs are in here already, too. Anyways, exiting out this way, we got the generator for this place, as well as the watchtower for the settlement, too. As you can see, this power pylon here comes with a ladder on it, and for pretend, it's as if we can climb this ladder to get up to this little watchtower. This is a pretty awesome watchtower. It definitely feels like a scavenger's watchtower. Flows nicely with the theme we got going on here. There's a rug added to the top so we can stand up here comfortably. There's also a lantern up here for some lighting, a mattress, a radio, and two chairs to keep watch. Overall, it gets the point across, and I love how the power pylon is set up so it seems like scavengers could just climb up here and, you know, be on guard for the settlement. It's also pretty awesome that we got a cranberry farm literally right by the settlement, too, with all of those gourds over there in the farm. It's definitely beneficial, once again, to make loads of cranberry relish. Helps out with extra experience. But anyways, let's go ahead and get off the scavenger's watchtower now and continue the tour. This time, we're going to be heading right outside the scavenger woodcutter's house. Let's go ahead and go on inside this area. This way leads to two more of the scavenger's homes that are settling here. We just saw the one that was pre-made from Bethesda. But yeah, through this little hallway here, added another little house. Nothing too spectacular here. It's literally just for sleeping and changing and whatnot. As you can see, there's a bed, a suitcase right below the bed, a dresser and whatnot. Hey, it's pretty convenient for a scavenger to sleep. And over here, someone important lives here that's settling in the settlement. Because it's a bit more fancy than the other buildings. It has a bit more things in it, and it feels a bit more fancy because of the fireplace here. But yeah, whoever's living here has a little kitchen area, an area where they can dine at, a place where they can store their clothes or whatever, inside the locker, the clock, and the walls are supposed to look not super fancy. Once again, we're still trying to stick with the scavenger theme, but someone higher up basically lives here. Maybe the person who started the settlement or something, I don't know. But yeah, they got a little fireplace in here too with a nice view, the dried up little riverbed. And when you sit, you get a nice view of it. Kind of. This centerpiece is kind of blocking the way there. You know what, I wonder if a single window would make that view look better. Let's test that real quick. Oh yeah, love the single window look, way better. Also, I got the Myrlurk claw hanging above the fireplace in a lake picture here. And the reason why I got a Myrlurk claw hanging above the fireplace is because Myrlurks do spawn here quite often. And there's a Myrlurk queen nearby at the Cranberry Farm that's right by this place. The farm, to put it simple, can be pretty dangerous if you're not as prepared to fight. Anyways, let me go ahead and show you the architecture to this build now, because it is a bit different than the others. Because I wanted to add a chimney because there's a fireplace inside. So yeah, that's what makes it a little bit different, as you can see. And by the way, in case some of you may want to make this for yourself, it's not difficult whatsoever. Let me go ahead and show you real quick. Oh my gosh. Failing here to get on top of the roof. Okay. There we go. Let me go ahead and just store this real quick. So as you can see, I added a modern fireplace on top of a table. And the table is on top of a roof. And then just added half walls around that little setup. And then I added this roof at the top. It allows me to place it. Which, by the way, the modern fireplace is an atomic shop item. You'll just have to wait for that to come around in the shop if you're wanting it. So anyways, carrying on to the tour, we got a pretty nice view from up here of the landscape. What's my partner back there doing? She must have to go use the restroom or something. I don't know. Oh, I forgot to mention this too. There's plenty of water as well around the farm. So, yeah, that's something also pretty convenient. Oh, and before I go ahead and head on over to this side where the scavenger woodcutter is, let me go ahead and show you this little secret I added in the settlement that I was majorly inspired from Bethesda by. As you can see, right here is a pathway that we can take, and back here is a random plushie sitting on a chair. I majorly thought about Bethesda when I added this, because they add all kinds of like random gnomes and plushies in the most random places. Secretive places too, sometimes. Oh no, I had fun adding that one. Anyways, let's head over here to this side. As you can see, starting off with this contraption here that I made. In case you're wanting to make this for yourself, what I did was blueprint two of these posts. As you can see, they're two of the short posts, which you can find these in the staircase category, right here. And the thing is, you can't exactly place them here, but if you have a blueprint, which I do, bam, you can place them in areas where you typically wouldn't be able to place them at. It's actually pretty convenient. So what I did was added a street light here, and then I added both of them on each side so I could hang up these little advertisements. On this side, I have a food advertisement because, you know, this is where you can get your food at. This is a little restaurant I made for my ally. Nothing too spectacular. It's supposed to be like a little trailer turned into a restaurant. Anyways, on this other side, I added the Night of the Fishman's Revenge. Honestly, the reason why I added this one is because I just thought it blended well with the environment. Anyways, carrying on. I forgot to mention, by the way, I made this little trailer here, but I didn't decorate the inside. The decorating was done by MysticStorm9431. Overall, I think she did a great job making this into a diner. And I don't know if you guys have seen this new ally or not, but this is one of the new allies, the cooking one. Her name is Yasmin, and this is the stove that spawns her in. It's pretty sweet. You can even see the burners lit on this. Oh, and by the way, if you don't know, you unlock her in the current scoreboard. She's not too far in either. She's right here. Not too far in. Oh, what the? Where'd she go? I like how this sign is above the sink here, too. I love the little things. Little things definitely matter when decorating. Anyways, let me go ahead and shut that. As you can see, also outside here, I got available here, food and drink. A little picnic table, if people want to eat outside or not. And, oh, whoops. There's supposed to be a light on this dead light. I'm not exactly sure why it's not on there. But yeah, as you can see right now, that light doesn't work. But something that blends well with it is this light here. It actually looks like, you know, it belongs. Blends really well by using what Bethesda already incorporated in the game here. And not to mention, it lights up the structure a bit more too. This structure makes the settlement feel more unique, and so does that one and that one over there. Just because all of these were added from Bethesda. You can't technically build this yourself. You can build something kind of similar to it though. I love seeing things that we can't actually build incorporated in people's camps. Also, speaking of things that we can't build, I would love to see this as a camp item. This fishnet over these crates here and barrel. That would be so sweet if we could place something like this around. Definitely gives all fishermen vibes for sure. As you can see, there's my scavenger woodcutter and Yasmin hanging out. Anyways, also behind the trailer here, I got a dumpster. And over here is a pre-made bridge from Bethesda. And up here is a little defense tower for the settlement. And I got a porta potty in the back of the diner. Just in case if someone has to go, they have somewhere to go. I know it's kind of a trek to get back there, but hey, at least it's something. Anyways, last but certainly not least, I want to go over the scavenger woodcutter here, which as you can see, I made a path over to him. It was kind of a pain. I couldn't get a foundation to place here, but for some reason, this encampment bridge worked. I don't know why. I got the foundations to place here, but I couldn't place it there. But hey, this worked. So, whatever. At least it worked somehow. Which, by the way, this is a part of the atomic shop as well, in case you're wondering about this. Maybe back around in the atomic shop sometime. I'm not exactly sure. But over here in the scavenger woodcutter section, I got a wasteland love seat just because I thought it flowed with him cutting wood. Also have a spit above a campfire here. to make it seem like he's the one keeping the fire going and doing a bit of the cooking. Or maybe Yasmin comes back here and helps him with a bit of the cooking or takes the meat that he has fried up. I don't know. I just tried to make it seem like he has more involvement here besides just chopping wood. Also, there's this thing right by him too. But yeah, this is his little spot, his little sanctuary that I have created for him. Now let's go ahead and get into more about the scavenger. I saved this part for last just because I wanted to do the whole tour over the settlement first before getting into this, because there is quite a bit of options to go over with this guy. As I mentioned before in the beginning, he can give you 3 bulk wood, which is a pretty insane amount. That's 90 wood scraps. But wood scraps isn't the only thing that he can give you. Keep in mind, he is a scavenger after all. So yeah, let's go ahead and talk to him and get more into his dialogue options.
I'm afraid I've split more logs than I can use. Would you like some?
So as you can see, we got quite a bit of options here. I'm going to go ahead and go over all of them, just to let you all know what is said and what you're rewarded with each option that you choose. Let's get into this.
I wasn't expecting any payment at all. Here you go. A little compensation for your generosity.
So the 20 caps one I showed in the beginning, you guys already know you get 3 bulk wood out of that, but I didn't play how he responds when you give him the 20 caps. Anyways, let's go ahead and get into the other options now. This is going to take a while to cover all these because I can't just repeat talking to him over and over. Once he gives me the wood, it takes a while for him to have the options again. I just hop servers until I'm able to talk to him. Just an FYI, I wish I could continue talking to him and just giving him 20 casts or 3 bulk wood. It's definitely worth it, but no, it doesn't work like that, and it makes sense why. Anyways, now since I made that clear, I don't want you guys thinking that you can just continue to get 3 bulk wood over and over and over, because that is not how it works. You're going to have to hop servers until you have the options available from the scavenger again. Now let's get into the 12 and higher perception option.
You noticed. Here, I'm glad you'll find this useful.
So once again, as you saw there, if you go with the perception one, 12 and higher, you'll still get 3 bulk wood. You just don't have to technically give them 20 caps. Although I feel like giving them 20 caps is more of the right thing to do. But yeah, that's another route that you can go to get 3 bulk wood. Now let's go ahead and choose the strength option.
Well, after a day of swinging my axe, the last thing I want to do is make multiple trips carrying all of this. Here. Thank you.
So for the strength option, as you saw, we only got 2 bulk wood instead of 3. Anyways, now let's go ahead and respond with, sure, I could use the wood.
Great. Here's a few of those logs.
So he doesn't give you hardly anything if you just say sure. So keep that in mind when talking to this guy. Oh my gosh, just a couple wood scraps compared to 90? Definitely don't go with this option. Anyways, lastly here, let's see what happens when we just say no to him.
That's a real shame.
So, nothing really special happens there. Seems like the best options to go with is the perception one or giving him some caps. Anyways, like I mentioned before, there's other stuff besides just wood that he can give you, such as some aid items, as you can see here.
Seems like you need a little help. Here you go. Be safe.
There's also another encounter with him where he's needing his medicine. And here's what happens when you give it to him.
Got any chems? I just don't feel right without my medicine. If I just had my Calmex, I could focus and stop fretting about the little things. Oh, perfect. That's the good stuff. Thank you. Here, you can have these. I won't be needing them now.
He rewards you with, ironically, an addictal. Anyways, you can also get some ammunition from him as well.
If you need some ammunition, I can help.
I got a more rare kind of ammunition when I went with the Charisma 12 and higher.
I found this the other night. I think you'll be interested.
However, it did seem like these options were more rare to encounter rather than just getting wood from them. So keep that in mind as well. But still, it's pretty cool to know. I'm sure a lot of you can tell I have spent a lot of time at this location. Probably too much time in server hopping, but at least I figured out a little bit more information and provided it to hopefully help out in some kind of way. Whether something in the build maybe can give you some inspiration, or you might learn something new with the cranberry relish and brain bombs, or something else. Hopefully something in here helped you out in some kind of way. I'm out of here though, everyone. Thanks for taking the time watching and listening. Until next time, remember to try to stay safe out there during these unusual times. Peace.